So my cookie jar, try to get it in screen, is all painted. And after doing a couple of mock-ups on my iPad, get into it. So I originally wanted to do something like this, because it would match my kitchen decor. Of course, it's my husband's house too. He wants a more Christmassy colors, and so he has chosen this. I did play around with like coloring out all the details, and we just really didn't like that. So I am going to go with Christmas colors. However, I want a red background, and I'm gonna put the greens and a different shade of red and pearl and gold as the stripes. So that being said, I'm going to repaint my whole house with Dixie Belle. Let me see if I can get this. It is Dixie Belle Honky Tonk Red. And so it is a chalk mineral paint. I do like Dixie Belle. When I did a lot of furniture, I used Dixie Belle. So I have a lot of this, and it has great coverage. And so since this is such a big surface, I'm gonna go ahead and use the Dixie Belle to cover it. And then when I get ready to do the stripes, I will use traditional acrylic paints. So I am going to get everything ready, and we will get this guy repainted and wait for it to dry. I know. Okay. Just like yesterday, I've got my bristle brush, and I'm going to cut off the feathers. Since I'm changing colors, I have to change brushes. And so, and then I kind of flick it to get any of the loose. Let's see, shake this guy up. I don't know if I've ever actually used this color. I have. See how pretty it is. I'm going to actually stir this up. I'm gonna get this started, and then I will speed this up for you. So you won't have to watch this whole thing. Which I probably would have painted it white to begin with, so I mean, I'm not really losing any time. I personally like to start with a white canvas, so if I had tried to use this red over the original brown color, and if you guys want to see the part one of where I prep and clean this guy, I will link it up here in somewhere on the screen. And you can stop this video real quick, go and watch that. It's not the most thrilling video, it's just really me cleaning, giving some tips and tricks on how to make sure your piece that you buy from the thrift store is nice and clean and ready for paint. So I'm gonna get this top one done, and then I'm going to speed up this video and you can listen to some nice relaxing music while you see me do this in full speed. I just don't want any puddles of paint anywhere, so I'm kind of, there is a bristle. All right, out there, guys. Oh, there's a future one. Nope, it's still attached. Guys, I'm going to speed this up, and so just enjoy some music while I finish getting this covered. Measure for the tape, only because I don't want it to be cockeyed. So this is 7 inches. We're gonna go to this little mark here. I'm just using a paint marker so that I know that it will show up on this. And I'm grabbing the middle one first. I'm gonna go above the paint line. So we're gonna go right there. Turn it over. It's right here. And where I can smooth it down, I will, but like on that window, I can't. This is gonna be fun to paint. Okay. I really hope this tape doesn't pull up the paint. Below. So we're going to do the 4. Just want a skinny line, so I'm actually going to do 13. Get creative with your plaid patterns. I just want a combination of thick and thin. So. Thank you. just a little bit so that it will lay a little bit closer down. Okay, let's get this top part. Measure that way. Alright. We're going to, let's go to the 22 mark. Oh goodness. Okay. Now that I got it marked, maybe it won't be so hard. Alright. I got a mark here. I got a mark here. I don't know how the plaid is going to turn out on this. Alright, let's see. Tear that off. Okay, I'm back. My battery died. I knew it was about to die. So, alright, I have one up here, but I think that's all that I'm going to do that way on there, because, well, no. Let's see. I go here. Cooperate. to cut. I know this is off camera. Alright. I'll show you in just a second what I did. Alright. I don't know how well that's going to look. So, I kind of just did it there. Let's do this side. Like a terrible blade. All right. All right. All right. I'm gonna gather up some of the supplies and I'll be back. Thinking about this while I went and got my wonderful lunch, which is my new favorite at the moment. It's Greek yogurt, organic honey peanut butter, some bananas, and some granola with a little dash of honey sprinkled over it. It is so yum yum. So I decided that the tape on here, on the top, was not going to work. So I took a mechanical pencil and I drew lines all the way around. And so the top will not be as good. I don't know. We'll see. Okay. I think I'm going to go with this grass green first. I think I'm going to work from dark to light. So we're going to do grass green. I've got some iridescent white. I've got another green. It's oxide green. And I've got cad red. And then I have true red. I have unbleached titanium. I have natural gray. And I've got some gold over there in the other section. I might do gold lines instead of black lines. So, okay, I'm gonna finish my lunch and we will get to painting this. Okay, we're back. Oh, I forgot to close my marker from earlier. Let's put these over here. These over here. We're going to, like I said, start with this grass green. And we're going to open up the container. It will be more exciting that way. I've never used this color. All right. I think I am going to mix just a little bit of iridescent in with this because I want it to be just a smidge. I want it to a smidge shimmery. My dog's whining. What you whining about? Without whitening it too much. So I feel like once you go iridescent on one color, you need to go throughout the whole thing, or else it just doesn't flow right. So I have to remember to make all my colors iridescent. All right, let's find a brush. We're going to go with the square 6. I'm just going to paint the top right now, so I'm going to move the bottom out of the way just so it's not taking up so much space. All right, we're going to start with these lines over here. All right, so this was my tape. So I'm going to paint below it with the green. It looks really black on the camera, but it is, might need to be lightened. I don't want it to be too dark. If you just take your brush and push it down, the side will create you a straight line. So I'm going to turn it around and do the other side so I can keep it, which one I'm working on, which tape line I'm working on since I took the tape off. So put in the comments what color combination you would have done, or what design you would have put on this. Like I said, I gave my husband kind of the final, let him choose. And this is what he came up with. All right, these sides. All right. So see, paint would have been there. I need to go a little bit lower on this one. Going to kind of draw us an imaginary line. Yeah. Sorry, I got quiet. I can't think and talk at the same time. Let's do this back side. Same thing. I'm just gonna first band is done. And a gazillion more to go. Okay, so we had... I think I'm going to do just one small little strip up here on the top.
Thank you.
All right, I'm gonna work on another area while that's drying. Let's do, let's see, we've got green, we got red. I'm gonna do some white. I'm gonna do a small band here in the center. I think I'm gonna change brushes. This is the reason why you want to make sure that you take your brush out of the water. See it bent? It's because I left it in the water and it bends that way. And I don't know if there's a way to get it back. That's why I buy so many brushes. And I buy the cheap brushes because of that. Let's do a number 5. It is just going to be a thin one. Load up my brush. We're going right in the center. There's lots of little indentions in this. Okay, so where's my ruler? Better. Do these top parts first. Go across this guy's face. One across her face. It's like they're wearing masks over their eyes. All right. Yeah, that line is not straight. Dry. Tiny brush. Thin this out. I'm gonna see if I can straighten this line a bit. A little crooked here. Okay. Bring the this down under her skirt a little bit. And I have to blast it with some hot air to dry it a little bit faster. I complete this thing without breaking it. We're gonna go underneath here a little bit. Some of that red. Really wondering if I should have gone lighter. Oh well. Okay. Just gonna blast this for a second with some heat. Brought my Christmas color. My husband's convinced that this is not Christmas, but it is. He totally picked the Christmas colors. Easy. If you put some tape down, you want to start at the tape and go down. You don't want to go up because then you're just sliding it under the tape. Just like sliding it right along the side. Okay. Let's get our ruler. Get my other brush. We're going to water this down just a bit. So it'll flow a little bit easier. Did it right. Yay, it should match up. myself just a smidge. All right, I'm gonna clean off the side of this ruler. As sure as I start to use it, it's gonna be like, ah, there is paint on it. There. All right, well, we have, cover that up. All right, I'm gonna put this down here and let that dry. Bring over the top again. What other color are we going to do? I think I'm gonna do some gray. Oh, that one hasn't been opened either. Okay. Once again, I'm just gonna put a small bit of iridescent in it. For the I'm gonna go with this size. It is a number 6. I'm gonna go right above every green line that I've made so far. Let's see how that does. Let me try something. I'm just gonna see if it works. Oh, it does. Okay. All right. So I've got my ruler just right above the green line. So I can get all the way to the end. And I'm just making a line all the way across. That looks good. See it? Alright, let's do this side. Right above this green line. Sides are not even. Crap. Alright, guys, I don't know how long I haven't been recording. And I won't know until I am editing. But, just to catch you up, because, like I said, I don't know when it stopped. I've put some green lines on it. And I'm working on some gray lines. And I've mixed some iridescent white in with both the green and the gray that I'm working with. And even though the tape was a good idea, I'd just rather freehand it. Okay, so I've got my green lines on, and now I am putting gray above the green lines. Okay, with this brush. I'm watering it down because it's a porous surface and it's just kind of like it's soaking up quite a bit of the paint. And I've given up on straight lines. I'd asked earlier, but I don't know if it was recording at that time, but put in the comments how you would have redone this cookie jar. What colors would you have used? Would you have just painted the design, or would you have just totally gone with something different? I really like bright colors. I'm just drawn to them. But I don't necessarily want them in my house. And I'm too old to have like rainbows and unicorns and things like that, even though I just think there is nothing prettier than a rainbow. I'm gonna let this dry and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. And I added a second coat of the green and the gray. And I'm about to mix up a lighter version of this red. I don't want it to be too pink. Let's see how this looks. I guess light red is pink, but let's see if this makes much of a difference. That's not the best brush. Here we go. This one's a little bit better. Let's see. I don't know if you're going to be able to tell much difference. Not really. Okay. Let's see what other color. Let's try. Some of this titanium bleached or unbleached titanium. I think I like that. All right, let's get those plates. Just go in. And I'm going to go around the side. No, it's off camera. I may have to put the red on this side just to even it out. Which one of these was the red? This was. We're going to put one on this line. looks good. Lots of little ornateness on this section. So I'm just gonna get it as straight as possible. Around. Now, after I get this on, I'm gonna put a couple of stripes of this on the bottom part, and then I think we're done with this direction. At one point I'm gonna have to take a white marker and just put a couple of white lines on it. All right, I might need a new towel. All right, the gray lines on this. All right, let's do the gray lines. Which one of these is my gray? This is my gray. Okay. To let those two sides dry. Okay. I haven't gone over this green, the second coat. Probably should, so it can all dry at one time. I have to clean my brushes. My water's getting a little muddy. doesn't show on the camera, but it's really quite pretty. But it is still dark. At some point you may see a lighter version pop up on the screen. I might change my mind. Kind of looks like a Christmas box. On this one, I'm going to do a very wide of the bleached titanium stripe across. Because like I said, it is very dark to me. And so that might help me a little bit. Alright. Let's do... wider. It's definitely going to take several coats. I'm gonna clean up a little bit and we'll be back. Okay. I'm starting to really regret the plaid design. I did pull out my Posca markers because the lack of straight, this is just, it was just bugging me. So, let's see. Life easier. I think it's going to. I just need some semblance of it. Being straight. The gold. And it too. Let's see how this is going to look. Oh yeah. Okay. I feel better now, knowing that this is not going to be a lost cause. Okay, I'm ready, I think, to start painting the other direction. Put it all together for you. As you can see, all right, I got a mess, but I do think I'm going to use these Posca markers. Do both. Okay, let's go here. I think I'm gonna draw the lines with these Posca markers and then paint them in with the paint. Okay. I'm going to go over this line and I'm going to go under this and then I'm going to go over these. And I should be using my ruler to get somewhat of a straight line. Skip this, and we're gonna go over this one. All right, I think we're going to go this wide. Skip that one. We're gonna go down here, up here, over here, down here. All right, so that will all be green. I do think I'm going to lighten up this green. Let's see. Yeah, I'm not gonna paint with these. Batch in case I don't like it. Pretty. Okay. We're gonna go with this one. There. That. But we're not going to go over that one. We'll go over there. Alright. I don't know why I didn't think of the Posca markers earlier. For some reason, I'm loving my markers, but I don't want to waste them. You made your way back around here, huh? All right. That looks great. Now, this next one, I want it to be a thinner one. We're going to do here. And here, let's stand up. There, and then we're going to go under this one, over this one, and stop there. This one, over this one, and stop there. go under that one. And over this one. I'm getting a Grinch feel. All right. Oops. I'll have to fix that. All right. I don't know why I'm getting a Grinch feel. I think it's just this bright green. Yay! What y'all think? You like it? Alright. These paper towels are gonna have to go. I'll just have to touch them up. Alright. Let's turn it over. Let's see, we went over, under, we're gonna go over. So we're gonna go over this. And I'm using this little line, so I'm not having to use the ruler. All right, we're gonna go under this one. And we're gonna go over this one. And then over. Under, oh, got a little hooky outy thing, over. Alright, this one's going to be a super thin one. I'm going to use this line here, so we're going to go under, over, under. Let me get my ruler because I don't want it to be very. I want it to just be tiny, tiny. So we're going to go all the way and then all the way. Yay! Yeah. Sometimes I just make life too difficult for myself. Mix this up a little bit. Oh yeah, I'm liking this so much better. And look, I even painted this one first instead of this one, so I wouldn't run into it. I'm learning. My battery died while I was drawing some lines, so. Alright. So, I've got all the green on the top. Now, let's do the gray. So, for the gray, we are going to go over this one and under this one, and we're going to go over this one. So, catch this up. This is the big wide one. There. Alright, guys, I think I'm just gonna do it to the end over here. Alright, so we went over. We are going to do under. We are going to do under here. Okay, so we're gonna go around here. We're gonna go over. And those greens are not eating up. I'm gonna have to, half this is going to have to be green and half of it's going to have to be gray. I don't know. It is what it is. Alright, so we went over, under. We are going to go over, over, and then that's going to be under. Then we've got the other side, so I am going to go ahead and draw my lines this other side. Okay. I know you can't see it, and so I will be right back because I got to do this. Alright, I'm back. I think I have all the lines drawn, and so now it's just a matter of painting them in. And so, let's start with the green. Actually, yeah, we're going to start with green. Alright. Ah! I said we're going to start with the green, and I dip into the gray, and I go on to the green. Alright. Let's try that again. We're going to start with green. That's too much paint. And these green and gray lines got all sorts of crazy up here on top. Alright, so this one goes over. This one goes over. And it stops. Dreading that little handle part. This project has made me think too hard. It has not been too relaxing. Usually, painting for me is relaxing. speed this up, because really I'm just going to be filling in these lines. Thank you. Hey Google, play some music. Hey Google, play some instrumental. Oops. Shoot. Frontier. I am gonna let this dry and touch up some areas. And then I'll be back. All right, I am gonna go in with this gold Posca marker and outline all of the lines. So that will take me a while. And then I think we can call this guy done. I will put a glaze over it. To make it shine a little bit more. So trying to keep up with where these lines are. Guys can see that, but it really does kind of tie it all together. All right, so I'm gonna get this done, and then once I get all that done, then I will be back. Right, here it is. It's all finished. I tried to add some embellishments that I'm not happy with. I might go back and just paint them solid. For example, I got a little crazy with the gold marker. I started adding little I don't know what you call them. So there's one side, there's the other side. Oh, anyway, overall, it was a learning experience. I don't know if I would call it my favorite, but it's done. And so now on to the next project. Thank you, guys.